Hello everyone, my name is Nimisha Bhatt and welcome back to the Cooking Hub. So today I bring to you a famous recipe that's called poutine chips. My dad used to always make for me these chips when I was in Nairobi, Kenya. And this poutine chips recipe is very, very simple. I mean, it's just like 3 to 4 ingredients and you have your poutine chips ready. And this is also a recipe that has a buttery flavor. So yes, you're going to love this recipe so much. Kids, adults, youngsters, everyone loves this recipe. So poutine chips is also a famous recipe in Nairobi, Kenya. I mean, whenever you go to any restaurants, you can order like garlic chips, poutine chips, masala chips. But when I came to India, I saw that poutine chips isn't so famous. So most of my friends and relatives say that, yeah, I should definitely share this recipe with you people. So here I am today sharing the lovely poutine chips recipe with you people. Trust me, it's a very simple recipe and you can prepare it within no time. Plus, it's I can't say that it's healthy, but it's going to be tasty. And yeah, if you have an oven at home, you can also bake the fries. That way it's going to be a bit healthy. But no, I don't have any oven, so I'm going to deep fry my fries before, and then I'm going to show you guys how to prepare the poutine chips. So poutine chips is simple, easy, only 3 to 4 ingredients, and there you have your poutine chips ready. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So to make the poutine chips, I'm heating up a pan. Next in, I'm going to add in some oil, like 3 to 4 tablespoons of oil, and some butter. This is like approximately 2 to 3 cubes of butter. So I'm going to allow the butter and the oil, the butter to melt and the oil to heat. So today for this recipe, I'm going to be using Kashmiri red chili powder and some paprika powder, which are easily available in the market. So poutine chips recipe is very easy and simple to make. You don't need so many ingredients. Now make sure to keep an eye on the butter. We don't want it to get burnt. Just on low flame. There we go, the butter is almost melting. So now at this stage, I'm adding in some ginger garlic paste. Ginger garlic paste, there we go. On medium flame, I'm going to mix it until the raw flavor is gone. Just 20 to 30 seconds. Okay, now at this stage, I'm adding in 1 tablespoon of Kashmiri red chili powder. So stirring in. Make sure the flame is low at this point. We don't want the red chili powder and the butter to melt. So stir in. Just 10 to 15 more seconds. Next in, I'm going to add some salt to taste. Remember, I've not added any salt in my fries, so I'm just going to add all the salt over here. Stirring in on low flame. Just 10 more seconds. So at this stage, I'm adding in 1.5 lemon juice for that nice sour and tangy taste. Now mix it well. Continue stirring this for 10 seconds. Next in, I'm adding in some black pepper. You can adjust according to the spiciness of your taste. So I've added the black pepper. I'll mix it. So this tempering looks like it's ready. So we've added all the ingredients, Kashmiri red chili powder and all. Now the only thing that's left is paprika powder. So here I'm using Spanish paprika powder. You can use any paprika powder of your choice. So I'm going to add 1/2 tablespoon of the paprika powder. There. So I'm going to mix in well. Just 10 more seconds. You can see the tempering is almost releasing oil. Make sure not to keep the flame on high, because if you cook this on high flame, it might get burnt. So this looks like it's ready. So I already have some fries. As you must have seen my French fries video, I've prepared some fries. So I'm going to be adding the fries into it. So I had prepared this beforehand. So I'm adding the fries. So I've taken 3 medium-sized potatoes and hand-chopped them into fries. Now I'm going to add it all inside and I'm going to toss it. At this stage, I'm going to off the flame. We don't want anything to get burnt. So I'm going to mix it and coat all the fries with the tempering. It might take some time. Just be careful to mix everything well. So let me mix this slowly by slowly until everything is well incorporated. So as you've noticed, I've offed the flame. Okay, so mixing it well. So we've added lemon juice, we've added black pepper, we've added paprika powder, Kashmiri red chili powder and salt. This recipe is completely ready. I'm not going to on the gas or anything. I'm just going to stir in. So this recipe is ready and it's almost ready to be served. But lastly, I prefer adding some chili sauce in Puzin chips. So a moment, I'm going to add in some chili sauce. Now you can add chili sauce as per your preference. I'm going to add in 1 tablespoon of red chili sauce. If you're making it for kids, you can add in ketchup if you wish to. So 1 tablespoon of chili sauce goes inside just for that nice spice. So me and my husband, we really like eating Puzin chips. It's completely our favorite. So I almost make this every time for him. So I'm going to mix in well. There we go. This Puzin chips is completely ready to be served. If you wish, you can add some more butter, but I'll keep mine like this. So this recipe is ready to be served and let's serve. So the Puzin chips is looking very yummy and very mouth-watering. It's ready to be served. So I have a nice black platter over here in which I'm going to be serving the Puzin chips. As I said earlier, you can add in some butter if you wish to, but I'm keeping mine like this. My mom and my dad love Puzin chips. My sister loves as well. So it's one of my favorite. Well, I'm about to introduce this recipe to my in-laws as well. As this recipe isn't so famous in India, I prefer teaching this to my Indian friends and family. So how tempting does this Puzin chips look to you? Do let me know in the comment section. Some more. To me, it looks amazing, delicious. I've just lost words. Just looks so good. And the final over here. Some more. Trust me, it's going to be tasty and amazing and delicious and yummy. You can make this on a winter evening. You can enjoy it with your favorite juice or soda. So I've added all the poutine chips. Now this recipe, according to me, can only serve one person, because me, I can finish these chips. Yeah, so I'm going to take half a lemon slice and put it over here, just in case someone who loves extra lemon can enjoy. So this chips is ready and I've served it. So do try this recipe and do let me know how it turned out for you. See the, you can see the color and the texture. Wow, it looks so good, so nice. Okay, so it's time for me to taste this recipe. So I'm so excited to taste it, or you may say to eat it. Yes, so let me taste and tell you guys how it is. Hello everyone, I'm back for the tasting. So taking some. So good, tangy, tasty, spicy, buttery. Even without adding garlic, ginger and chilies, I prepared this recipe and indeed it's yummy. I'm so happy. Kenyan recipes rock, always. It's out of this world. I'm feeling so happy. It was very tasty. So, if you like this recipe, please give me a thumbs up. Do comment below, share this video to your friends and family, and make sure to prepare this recipe for all your loved ones. Thank you so much for watching. I'm taking all those chips and running away. I'm not going to share it with anyone. I'm just joking. I'll share it with my husband. We both love this recipe so much. Poutine chips, best recipe, easy, simple. In case if you do not have the paprika powder, just use the normal red chili powder, no problem, but do make this recipe. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you around in the next video. Goodbye.